Goers and learners, welcome to Code to Link. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to print your first Java program using BlueJ as the editor. Let's print Hello World using BlueJ. For this, you need to double click on this icon of this kind, which is called a BlueJ icon. Once you double click on it, you will come across a window of this type. Click on Project, New Project. Select the name of your project here. Write the type of the name of your project. Select the correct location wherever you want to store that project and click on OK. So, as you come across this window, you click on New Class. Type out the name of the class. For the time being, you can just name anything. So, I'll just name G and say OK. You can later on change the name of the class. Double click on this icon, select all using Ctrl A, delete, and now you have a plain screen to type out your class. Now any Java program begins with the keyword class in the beginning. So we write class and we write the class name. Let's say first underscore program. Remember, when you give a project name or a class name, you are not supposed to leave any spaces in between. Instead, you can use underscore. Once you write the name of the class, you need to design the boundary of the class by giving a curly brace and press enter. You will automatically have a closing brace. So this is the boundary of your class. Within the class, the next statement that you type is a main method. So any name followed by parentheses is called a method. And then you decide the boundary of the main method. So here you have a yellow block defining the boundary of the main method. But what is a method? What is a main method? I will discuss soon in the upcoming videos. When we write a main method, we do not just write main. We write certain keywords with it, like public, static, void, main. We write these words. Each of these words I will be explaining soon. So that's the main method. Now here, because I want to type hello world, I will connect the system output and use the print method and pass the parameter say hello world as a string, close it and put a semicolon. Now let me explain this particular line. System.out.print. Now dot is an operator. We connect the output system to the print method. We pass on a series of characters which are enclosed in inverted commas, forming a string. So in Java, anything that you type inverted commas is considered as a string. A series of characters enclosed within inverted commas is called a string. So that's what a string we have passed on here. And voila, we are done with our first program. Now, whether we have written this program correctly or not, we will find out using this compile icon. So I'm clicking on compile, and if there are no errors in your program, towards the end, you will see something like this, compiled, no syntax errors, okay? So if you find something like this, means your program is correctly compiled. Let me show you some error in case if you've forgotten to put a semicolon here. Semicolon in Java generally works like a full stop in English, okay? So majority of your Java statements, you will end up using a semicolon. Suppose I have missed out a semicolon here and I try to compile this, I will see something like this saying errors found in the class. Okay, and also you will find a red line kind of a thing indicating the error lies here. So if I put a semicolon, I again try to compile the program, it says class compiled, no errors. So this is the first Java program printing hello world. Now as I've compiled the program, you will see the class which I gave the name as G has turned to whatever I wrote in the class as the class name. First program, right? Now we will right click on this icon and go down to void main. Main is the function, the method which I wrote in this program. I will click on void main and I will be able to see the terminal window of my first Java program printing hello world on the screen. So this is how you will be able to type out your first Java program and see the output on the terminal window. If you have liked this video, consider subscribing and consider sharing it with like-minded people. Happy learning, and I'll see you in the next video.